Hello, class. We have finished another week and we are going to review depth, value, and illusion, all things you learned this week. And then you also have a response assignment. So depth is the creation of the illusion of space within a 2D artwork. The image appears to contain multiple dimensions. And remember, you can use visual depth by you can create it with perspective, value, hierarchy, and tone. So when you look at this picture, and if you're asked to identify depth in this picture, that is how you have the illusion of looking down that long hallway to whatever is back there at the very, very tiny point at the end of the hallway. That's what depth is. It looks like it goes back into space. Value is the amount of light. When something is white, all the colors are reflected equally. When it's black, you have the absence of light. Gray is a mixture of black and white. Tint is a light gray. It's between white and gray. A shade is between gray and black. And a value scale is a range of values from white to black. Gradation is a gradual change of value from white to black. You learned this and you made a value scale, and then you did a gradation scale, and then your creative drawing was holes where you used values. So looking at the Alice picture, you can see all the values are in here. There is white in her apron, and it's also on the floor in areas and on the rabbit in areas. Black is the darkest value, and that's found in the shadows, like part of her hair that's in shadow, where the cornices are, that's the braces for the hallway. They are black. Some of the areas on the door is black, underneath her skirt. And then there's lots of different grays. The mid-tone gray, middle of the road gray, is probably the gray that most of the hallway is. Okay, it's just kind of a mid-range gray. And then tints of gray would be the light grays in the floor, the light grays in her dress and her skin, the light grays on the rabbit. A shade of gray would be dark grays on the dress that's further away from you, and on the beams that go across the ceiling. Those are shades of gray. It's a blended gray, so it's a gradation. So reviewing back towards week one, our criticism and what that is. Our criticism is writing about art, and the parts of art criticism are description, what it physically looks like, and you wrote a descriptive paragraph in week two. Analysis, which is how the artist used the elements and principles in the composition, and you're going to write one of those today. Interpretation is what the artist is communicating. And evaluation is the strengths, weaknesses, and comparison to other artworks. So some reminders for writing. Paragraphs are five or more sentences. Use Google Docs, the default font and color. Make sure you check your spelling and grammar, and then fix your mistakes. And as always, you can write in Spanish or English, whatever your language of choice is. So your assignment for the critical response is start off by studying the image. You're writing about the image on the right, which is M.C. Escher's Relativity. And you're going to write an analytical paragraph about the art that answers the following questions. So answer these in a paragraph, okay? How did the artist create visual depth? Think about how you created depth in your creative assignment. What did you do to make it look like there were holes and layers of the paper? How did the artist use value to change the directions of the stairs? So for this, look at the values on the staircases, the three main staircases are the three that form kind of a triangle in the middle. And see where the white parts are, the lightest parts, where the darkest parts are, and the medium parts, because that's what helped to change direction. What illusion is created by perspective here? In other words, what does it look like is happening as far as the space goes? And then which way is up and why do you think that? Okay? So it's a tricky image, but I know you can do this. So I don't want you to tell me what it means or anything like that. Just, again, write a paragraph that answers how did the artist create visual depth? How did the artist use value to change the direction of the stairs? And how are the values different on the three main staircases? What illusion is created by perspective? Which way is up and why do you think that? Okay? Next week we will be on to something else.